Okay, so in continuation to the yesterday's topic, VMware HA, I've asked one question yesterday. What is that? So if you consider you have a three host, right? If you consider you have a three ESXi host within one cluster. And you have a cluster. Prod underscore cluster. And I said, if you have a shared storage, okay, rest of the prerequisites are same. You have a shared storage or SAN storage attached to all the three ESXi hosts. Okay, and what we did, if the host is down, we have seen these VMs. If host is down, imagine you have three different VMs on this host. These VMs, they restarted one here and one here. Another one is down because it is running on local storage. This is what we tested yesterday. Okay, today we'll understand how it is working in the backend. There are few controls that you can keep in place or that you can put in place, I can say, in order to control the HA very efficiently. Okay, so what it is, let's see. So I have asked one question yesterday. Okay, I said if all the three hosts are 90% full, then what you will do? Nice. Yesterday's question, you remember? Okay, let's take an example. Okay. Notepad. I have ESXi host with 1 TB RAM. Okay, how many hosts I have? Three hosts. What is the total cluster size? 3 TB. RAM is a cluster size. I said 90%. 90% is full. How much? 3 TB. 90% of 3 TB. 2.7 TB is full. This is the condition. Okay. So if this host is 1 TB, 90% full means how much? Around 900 GB. Around 900 GB RAM is used. Agree or disagree? Okay, and this is also 90% full means this is also 900 GB used, and this is also 900 GB RAM used, means there are n number of machines running on these three hosts. Now if host went offline or dead or down, whatever you call it as, how much capacity will go down? Capacity will go down 900 GB machines will be in offline mode for 5 minutes. Agree? If this host is down, all the machines are down, means around 900 GB machines are down. Okay, what I said, if this is master, this is slave, this is slave, master will pick all the machines and restart here. But if you look at 900 GB is full, 100 GB is free. 900 GB is full, 100 GB is free. Then it has 900 GB requirement. You have only 200 left. What you will do with the rest of the 700 gig in Lehman calculation I'm talking about. Okay, and moreover, you will not use these three hosts up to 100% limit. Now, how your HA will work in this condition? Okay, so just to control these kind of scenarios, there is a mechanism called VMware High Availability Admission Control Policy. Admission Control Policy. If you go to vCenter, vSphere HA, Admission Control, Failover Responses. If host is failed, host enable host monitoring, enable. If a host is failed, okay, vSphere HA, what it will do? It will restart it. It will restart the machines. Host response, restart the VMs into other. If I disable it, it will not restart any machine even if the host is down. Okay, so you have to enable it. Rest all, I'll leave it default. A lot of other options came into picture in 6.7. We'll have to review it. Okay, I will have to go through some of the portals and do some testing. We have to do some R&D on this. But traditionally, we have these options which are already in production in 6.5, 6.0, or 5.5. Okay, all these versions will have these options. Using admission control policy, you can control this mechanism. Okay, so in admission control policy, the first option is host failure cluster tolerates. What is that? First option. Please take the first option. What is that first option? Host failure cluster cluster tolerates one. Okay, typos. Right, one means what? Means what? Means if you go to this picture, this cluster is there. No, this cluster is combination of some host. How many host in our lab? 3. In real time, maximum 64. Okay, now this cluster is running with 3 hosts. Imagine running with 40 VMs. Example, okay? Running with some 40 VMs. Okay, so if I said host failure cluster tolerates equal to 1, means what? Within the cluster, if one host goes down, don't worry, I will take care of the production. Means what? Even if you have 3 hosts, one is down, okay, if you are running with only two hosts now, okay, still all the 40 VMs will up and running on these 2 hosts. That is what it says. Host failure cluster tolerates equal to 1 means if I have a 64 host and around 1500 VMs, okay, in that case, if one host goes down, you have a 63 host, right? It's okay. With the 63, I will run all the 1500 VMs, no problem at all. If two hosts goes down at a time, if two hosts goes down at a time, means 62 hosts are in production. No warranty whether I can bring all the machines are up and running, because host failure cluster tolerates equal to 1 I have set. How it works? Let's take an example. Now this has 1 TB, this is in general calculation. Now let's take, this has 1 TB RAM, this has 1 TB RAM, this has 1 TB RAM. Okay, what is the total cluster capacity? 3. This is normal capacity. Normal capacity, understood? Cluster capacity is 3 TB. Now, if I say host failure cluster tolerates, host failure cluster tolerates equal to 1 means out of 3 hosts, one host capacity will be in reserve state, means 3 TB minus 1 TB, 2 TB is the 2 TB is the 2 TB is production capacity, means customer can use only 2 TB. Understood? If I say host failure cluster tolerance equal to 1, you have a 3 host. One host capacity you have to minus, and rest of these RAM sizes used for production. How it will calculate? So 3 TB divided by 3 TB minus 1, 3 TB minus 1 equal to 2 TB divided by how many host? 3. How much? 2000. Take 2000 divided by 3. How much? 666 GB. Agree?
Yes.
Approximately. Okay. What it will do? It will create a boundary. It will create a boundary. So 3 3 3 reserve, 3 3 3 reserve, 3 3 3 reserve, 6 6 6 usable. Upper part you can run your production, lower part is reserved for high availability. If you combine 3 3 3 1000, one host capacity in reserve. Understood? Okay. Now, from your point of view, if a production cluster capacity, you are asking about production cluster capacity, how much? 2 TB is my total production capacity. That is what customer can see. But in the back end, you have 3 TB. That's a different story. Okay. Now, in this scenario, if one host goes down, how much capacity that it requires to restart production? This upper part only, right? Lower part you cannot use it. Means this is your 100% capacity. Even though if your host is showing 1 TB, you cannot go beyond 666 GB RAM. That is your 100% capacity as far as customer is concerned. So if this host goes down, how much capacity you require? How much capacity you require in production? 666. You combine these two.
Equal to that.
Okay. Half of the capacity, half of the VMs will come and restart here. Half of the VMs will come and restart here. Satisfied the condition? Okay.
Yes.
Hypothetical. Let's take real time an example. Imagine same 1 TB. Cluster is there. Okay. 64 hosts. 64 hosts with 1 TB RAM. What is the total cluster capacity? 64 TB. Host failure cluster tolerates equal to 1, I said, means one host capacity is 1000 GB, example. Okay, so what is the customer capacity? Customer can use 63 TB only at, right, one host capacity you have to minus. Agree? Hello.
Yes, yes.
63 TB in production. Now, one host capacity, how much? One host capacity?
63.
Just a moment. Like this, you have 64 host in cluster. Okay. So 1 TB. 1 TB means 1000. Okay, otherwise 1024 you can take it, not an issue, divided by 64. How much? Let's open the calculator. 1000 1024 divided by 64, 16 GB. Okay, 16 GB. What it will do? It will reserve 16 GB in each host. 16 GB reservation for HA means even though if you have a 1 TB RAM, you cannot use full 1 TB. Okay, so what you can do, around 1000 GB you can use it approximately, and rest of the 16 GB in reserve for HA in each host. Agree? Okay, now now you see the calculation. If one host goes down, how much production capacity I require? 1000 GB, example. Agree? Now I have a 63 host in production. 63 hosts are reserved with 16 GB capacity on each. How much? 16 GB into 63, 1008. This much reservation I have. So all these VMs will come and restart in each host in a reservation capacity. Possible?
Yes.
Okay. If two host goes down at a time, so how much capacity you need? 2000 GB capacity you need. But how much you have in reservation? You have a 62 active servers into 16 GB reservation. How much it is? 62 active servers into 16 GB, 992 you have a reservation, but you cannot restart all the VMs. In this case, if a two host goes down at a time, you need this much capacity. Okay, but you have only 992 GB in reservation. What happens in that situation? Nothing will happen. Okay, you have to specify out of 2000, how many VMs are high priority, how many are medium priority, how many are lower priority. So based on the order, it will restart high priority first. And then it will calculate and see if a space is still there, restart the medium priority. If both the high priority and medium priority machines are powered on, if still the capacity is there, then it will go and restart the low priority. If the space is not left for low priority, it will leave those VMs offline until you go and fix the hardware problem. But as per condition, host failure cluster tolerates equal to 1, without any issue, it will restart everything. It will restart everything without any issue, because it is fitting in the calculation, right? If one host down, cluster will take care. If at a time two host down, cluster cannot take care everything, because you have set an admission control policy in such a way saying if one host goes bad, I will take care of everything. At a time two hosts are down, sorry, I will do my level best. You understood? Okay, but the condition is your host capacities are equal. Your host capacities are equal. In the sense, within a cluster, your host capacity, your CPU and RAM capacity is equal capacity, then only this formula will work. Otherwise, it will not work. Let's say one host is 250 GB RAM, another host is 1 TB RAM, another host is 750 GB RAM. Then how you will calculate this formula? Understood? Questions on this logic? Okay, VMware always recommends use same configuration, same RAM size, same CPU size, same vendor within one cluster so that you will get high performance, best outputs. Clear?
We have to hello.
Yeah, go ahead.
In order to get this facility, we have to enable that shit, right?
That by default this option. No. By default, when you enable it, admission control policy, host failure, cluster tolerance equal to one, it is set. Okay.
So if we like in our case, we didn't enable it before. We did it afterwards, like right now. So what will happen in this case? Like we have to do it before making the infrastructure, right? Like we, if we have created
can you, can you bit louder? I'm really sorry. Can you bit louder and speak loudly and speak clearly? I'm not able to understand anything.
Am I audible now?
Yes.
So in our case, so we created cluster way before, and this service today. So it is recommended that when we create a cluster, we have to enable it at that time only, right?
In real time production systems, okay. When you create a new cluster, the very next moment you will enable the HA. Okay.
Since
we are learning phase by phase, we haven't enabled it. This is learning class. This is not the production system.
Yeah. So if we like we are doing it now, it won't be that way, right?
It will help. The moment you enable it, HA start functioning. HA will calculate, and it will show you. Okay. Even if you have a production system overloaded already, then you enable it. Still, it will work, but it will do its level best.
Okay. So because at this time almost 90% of space is free utilized, so
that is what I'm saying. If your condition is not satisfying, your admission control policy condition is not satisfying, what it will do its level best. If a host goes down, what it will do, it will simply try to restart as much as it can and then leave rest of the things.
Okay.
If you want system should work for you, then you do it properly. If you want system should work against you, you do however you want. Okay. You want system works for you or against you? It's up to you.
Works for me.
That's it. Yeah. Okay. So you got the answer? That's the first point. Host failure, cluster tolerates equal to one. The condition is I'm considering all the hosts within a cluster are having the same capacity levels. If they have a different capacity levels, then that's a different scenario. That calculation won't work. Understood?
Yes, sir.
You want me to explain that in the picture notation? You're fine, you can imagine yourself. If you want, I can explain. Rest of the 2 points,
yeah,
we'll discuss.
I got it.
Okay. Now, my another question is, okay, you have purchased, or as a customer, you have purchased 10 hosts in 2017. 10 hosts, 1 TB RAM, each of 1 TB RAM, in 2017, okay, and you created a cluster, and you have enabled HA, host failure, cluster tolerance equal to one, okay, and it's functioning from 2017 to till date. Now the overall cluster capacity has reached 85%. Now it's time to add a new host, okay, and you are expecting scenario something like this. You are expecting some more business in this year, so you thought of adding 5 more servers to cluster.
Mm-hmm.
You thought of adding 5 more servers to cluster. When you place a request for new server purchase, okay, 2017, you purchase 1 TB for 10 lakhs. Now you have purchased, so you put the request. Now you are getting 2 TB with the same amount, 2 TB RAM servers with 10 lakhs. What you will do? No, no, I have a cluster with 1 TB. I'll go with 1 TB RAM only. You take 10 lakhs and give me 1 TB servers, or you take the 2 TB servers. You are getting a double capacity with the same amount what you have spent 3 years back. Now what you will do? Definitely you will go with the 2 TB servers.
Okay. Yes.
Now if you are getting a 2 TB servers, can we add those 2 TB server host into the existing cluster or not?
Yeah, it's a shared storage. Now we can increase the capacity, then it will recalculate, I guess.
I'm not talking about storage, I'm talking about RAM. I'm confused.
RAM. Sorry. So,
okay. VMware primary recommendation is, okay, if this formula you want this formula to be working efficiently, please do not add mismatched capacity. Means if one host is with 1 TB RAM, rest of the 63 hosts must be having the same capacity or a same CPU, same RAM, same configuration, same host, same vendor. That is what the recommendation says. But as a customer, you are getting 50% more capacity with the 50% less cost. Right? You're getting double capacity, in short, with the same amount you spent 3 years back. Definitely. Leave about the VMware features and all. First, get the servers. We are getting double capacity. You don't need to worry about it. Okay. Now, can we add those hosts into same cluster? Yes, you can add. VMware recommends. There is no limitation.
Right? Okay.
It is not a limitation. It is recommends that if you think your system should work for you, not against you, or should work properly, or should work perfectly, then use recommendations. Otherwise, it's up to you. You do what, however you want to do it. Okay. Anyway, I took a decision to purchase all the 5 hosts with 2 TB RAM. Existing setup having 10 TB, and now new setup with the 5 servers, I got 10 TB. I have reinstalled the ESXi servers in all the 5 hosts, added to the same cluster. Now, do you think this formula is going to work? Host value cluster tolerates? No, right? Because mismatch in the capacity. Now, how you will handle that situation? Okay, there are 2 more options. Okay, I gave you a hint. If you want, you can take a screenshot of these 2 options. You can do some R&D. I will explain in detail about that calculations and stuff, how you can manage those scenarios differently, that we will discuss tomorrow. Is that fine?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. So, I mean, I'm really sorry. I was stuck in another call, so I have to shrink down. I thought of completing all the scenarios in today's session itself, but it's fine. We'll discuss other 2 scenarios tomorrow. Okay. Any questions or any confusion? You understood how it works? Admission control policy. The first option is host failure cluster tolerance. Okay. So, So tomorrow we will discuss the rest of the 2 options. Okay. I'll stop here. Let's catch up tomorrow.